The sheets at the Kamloops Curling Club were buzzing with activity earlier this month as the Hub International Crown of Curling wrapped up once again.
18 teams, both ladies and men's, in a round robin format. Some excellent curling. Everybody raved about the conditions and the competition. It's a really good level of curling, both for, you know, the mainstays that have been on the circuit for a long time and the new up-and-comers.
Kelly Scott and her team made it to the ladies' finals, but fell short in their match against the Japanese team led by skip Ayumi Ogasawara.
We just didn't have a great grasp on the ice or the rocks. I don't know. We just had maybe slightly inconsistent results, and maybe when we could put some pressure on, then our next shot just didn't end up in the right spot and we'd let them off the hook. Certainly the Japanese team is a very solid team. They won Vernon tournament 2 weekends ago, and solid lead to skip. There's not many weaknesses in their game, so it was more, I think, about our play that we just couldn't really put 8 good shots in a row each end.
Scott says she and her new teammates have been working hard together. This event just one of several opportunities to further develop as a team.
It's been a really easy transition putting together this foursome. We're definitely all on the same page. I think everyone's really buying into the positive attitudes and the really good work ethic out there, and that keeps us going, and sometimes it gets us through a rough end during a game, just having that overall positive attitude on the team. And we've really enjoyed the 2 tournament weekends we've had so far. We're playing against teams, either these international teams or BC teams that we might meet up in our provincial playdowns. So it's just great competition. You don't get any better practice than competing in games.
Curling fans in Kamloops can look forward to the event again next year as curling in the tournament city shows no signs of slowing down.
In 96 we had the Brier, in 97 we had the Worlds, and then we had all the Canada Cups, and then we just recently had the Brier again. So curling is definitely a passion in the city of Kamloops. And just this is just a reminder that it just keeps going on an annual basis. It's not always the great big ones that you see on TV all the time. It's that there's some real world-class curling that happens in Kamloops every year.
Thank you.
For Shaw TV in Kamloops, I'm Sam Numsen.